I'm Mike Brandt with NASA's Office of Inspector General. For the past 20 years, the International Space Station has served as a unique laboratory in low Earth orbit to study the health effects of space travel on humans and demonstrate new technology work critical to enable humans to travel deeper into space. However, maintaining and supporting the ISS costs over $3 billion each year, or about half of NASA's annual human spaceflight budget. The President's 2019 budget request proposes ending direct federal funding of the ISS beginning in fiscal year 2025 in order to transition the station to commercial operation. If that timetable remains unchanged, NASA would need to manage its remaining time aboard the ISS extremely efficiently in order to complete as much health and human performance and technology-related research as possible. Of course, another option is to extend ISS operations until 2028 or beyond. And at some future point, NASA will need to dispose of the station via a controlled destructive reentry into the Earth's atmosphere. In this audit, we assessed NASA's progress in maximizing utilization of the ISS and evaluated the options and challenges associated with a potential extension of operations as well as the station's eventual retirement. We found that NASA continues to perform well relative to metrics that track on-orbit research and overall use of the ISS, such as crew time dedicated to research, number of investigations, and use of allocated research space. NASA is also making progress towards completing research into human health risk and demonstrating technologies on the ISS that will be required for future missions. That said, as of February 2018, the agency forecasted that research for at least 6 of the 20 top human health risks that require the ISS for testing and 4 of the 40 technology gaps will not be completed by the end of fiscal year 2024. In addition, research into 2 other human health risks and 17 technology gaps are not scheduled to be completed until sometime in 2024, meaning even minor schedule slippage could push their completion past the station's planned retirement date. As a result, NASA may be forced to choose from a variety of options, including extending operation of the ISS past 2024, relying on alternate testing methods, or accepting higher levels of risk for future crewed deep space missions. With respect to transitioning the station to commercial operation, we questioned the feasibility of NASA's plans to foster increased commercial activity in low Earth orbit on the timetable proposed. Specifically, we question whether a sufficient business case exists under which private companies will be able to develop a self-sustaining and profit-making business independent of significant government funding by October 2024. From our perspective, it is unlikely that a private entity or entities would assume the station's annual operating costs, currently projected at $1.2 billion in 2024, and manage the risks associated with continued operation of the station's aging systems and infrastructure. Moreover, the amount of savings NASA may realize through commercialization of the ISS may be less than expected, given that significant expenditures, particularly crew and cargo transportation costs for NASA-sponsored flights to low Earth orbit, coupled with ongoing civil servant and infrastructure costs, are expected to continue past 2025, even if many low Earth orbit activities transition to a privatized ISS or another commercial platform. Consequently, any assumption that ending direct federal funding frees up $3 billion to $4 billion beginning in 2025 to use on other NASA exploration initiatives is incorrect. That said, unless the agency receives a substantial increase in funding or can dramatically reduce costs, NASA will be hard-pressed to continue supporting ISS operations under its current model while attempting to fund NASA's other space exploration initiatives such as the Lunar Orbital Platform Gateway, a lunar orbit and moon landing, and preparations for a crewed Mars mission. Finally, we found the agency currently does not have the capability to ensure the ISS will enter the Earth's atmosphere and land in a targeted location in the South Pacific Ocean in the event of an emergency. We made 5 recommendations to help assure NASA is positioned to complete its critical human health research and technology demonstration projects and to provide for a safe decommissioning of the ISS. To read the OIG full report, please visit our website at oig.nasa.gov.